This is a little experiment. This is Vietnamese beef. I put a load of fat on it. All the silver skin. Now, these are some I already breaded. I'm going to hit them again. But this stuff is notoriously impossible to chew. It's like chewing a motorbike tire. The cuts are completely random when they butcher a piece of meat. So they cut with the grain, across the grain, any old way with the grain. So, the piece that formed out at market was done the same way. It was horrible. There was no rhyme or reason for the way it was cut, and it was impossible to make anything good out of it. Now, I'm gonna batter it a couple of times here. Bread it. Good heavy coating on it. Oh, towel. Put that on. Let's try and get a nice. Thank you. We'll try and get a nice heavy coating on it. A little bit of seasoning here. There's salt and pepper. This is just an egg and water mix. Salt and pepper, basil, a few other secret herbs and spices. Then I'm going to flash fry it. Put it in a pan. I'm going to make a baked steak. Or chicken fried steak. Now, this is an experiment to try with the Vietnamese beef. If this works, we can make a fancy chicken fried steak recipe. But when I do it for the show, we're going to do it two different ways. I'm going to do just the standard beef that we buy at the market here. And I'm also going to cut some nice pieces from the cube roll we have and do that. But the real test is to do it this way and see if this common market beef can be made tender after it's baked for maybe, I'll give it about half an hour in the oven. And we'll see what happens. But I'm making up enough here to do a little test run of it. Okay. I got most of the good stuff. The rest of that's a lot of fat. We'll use that for something else. Like maybe dog food. Very hot grease. And the just going to flash fry it for maybe 30 seconds on each side. Actually, not hot enough. A little more heat. Phone just walked by and turned this off when the heat was up to where it should have been. So we're starting from scratch there. Okay, now we're getting somewhere. Oh yeah. A little bit of a crust. Brown very well. Let that go for a minute there. Six pieces, that should be a good test. These are nice and crisp on the outside. Now this is everything it cooked off. I was frying the beef. And this is what I want for a gravy to put over the meat once it's in the pan. Throw in some garlic. Touch of olive oil. A little bit of Galette wine. Reduce the heat a little bit. Some milk. flour. And get a little out of this for a little bit of gravy. Smells pretty good. The lumps don't matter. So this is going to bake for about an hour. Right on my foot. This will bake for about an hour. So any lumps in the gravy will disappear. Besides, we have to I'll let that simmer for just a minute. This is something that everybody can do because all the Vietnamese here. The wine's cheap. I just use garlic, which is dirt cheap. Flour, cheaper than sand. Extend that a little bit. A little more flour to it. To this little stovetop burner because bending over the other one wasn't working this morning for me. Alright, now throw some milk in, turn it off. Doesn't have to be a dark gravy. Oh hell, one more wine. Just a little. So now we get purple gravy. Or mauve. Hey, Tao.
Yeah?
Some milk.
Yep.
Yep. I don't want to add any more water or milk. So we'll just throw some water in. Mmm. Damn, that tastes good. Burning up the blender in the background. I'm going to put it in a clear baking pan, which most Vietnamese don't have, but if this works, and that's not in the video, they can use one of the cheap ones they buy at the market. Alright, ready to rock. That's pretty nice. Now, I'll thin the gravy out a little bit more. Pour that on top. I'm not allowed to do that on camera when we're making the video. Alright. Got the oven preheated. About 375. I'm going to cover this nice and tight. I'm going to cover it tight because I want the steam that's created inside of that to cook the hell out of that. Alright. Okay, here we go. 1 hour. Whoa. This started at I think it was 180 degrees centigrade, and when everything started to boil, I reduced it to 160, and then after about half an hour, I reduced it to about 130. And let it finish that way. Now, this looks pretty good. Okay. You did stick to the pan a little bit. Ooh, but only a little bit. Okay, that's cool. See what we got. Some pieces are a little bit thicker than others, but that's right about an hour. Okay. Whoa, that's hot. Normally I'd let this rest. This is still red hot. It's cooked through all the way. Yep. Completely cooked. Now. There is some tendon. Gristle in there. It's not all a good piece of meat all the way through. But the test is, other than the gristle, is it tender? Still nothing like foreign beef. But for this kind of meat, it is really crap. You can actually chew it. So it's got a good flavor, and it is chewable. It's chewy. It's not tender, but it's chewier than most. The problem is, if I would have cut away all the silver skin, all the tendon, there wouldn't have been any beef left. That would have all been thrown away. So what's left goes to the dogs. And the rest of it we can actually eat.